mass about 60, the low 60s, short sleeve weather. It only gets into the 50s at night.
Money, okay, guys.
So, Lena, what's this place called?
I don't remember.
It's that. Just a bakery where they make the little
bread dough figures for
to celebrate
Day of the Dead.
Day of the Dead.
Yes.
But it's also a tourist place.
Let's see. I don't want to shoot into the sun.
I'm sorry. As I knock you out.
Yeah, hey, yeah, it's dinner.
I think we're going to have lunch here pretty soon. Just like
some other long strands for decoration. Everything is finished here. All of the decorations of each of the items. Then they leave them to dry. Then they get baked, and then they get shellacked. So what is interesting sociologically also is that this business is entirely run by women, which is rather unusual for bread. Women make the bread figurines and they commercialize it as well. There are things the industry is Christmas decorations nowadays for the tree.
I have no idea. Mostly, there's no monkeys in the highlands. All of the monkeys are in the coastal plains and on the Amazon. And they, in fact, did not care about respecting the culture or any of those things. But they were out. Nowadays,
this area is called Octavio. We're heading to a marketplace. And I guess there's several bikes down in here.
Sorry about that. I just realized our walk is
ready. It's okay. I guess we'll have Panama hats. Evidently, Panama hats come from Ecuador.
I put my money.
What's the inside?
It's from the squash family.
Really?
I've never seen it hang like that, though.
This is Samba. It's a member of the squash family.
I know, man.
I'm gonna go get the chef.
Special try. I'm not very fast.
Stick your camera out the window.
Tiana, time. We're having a celebration.
Celebration of the sun.
See, also.
This is the Equator Museum that we saw on our very first day there. Eduardo was explaining to us about the scientists that came at that time. And this is the museum in which you can travel up to the top and have a beautiful view over the area.
Right on the equator, remember. Okay. The Quito Airport. Got up at 4:30 this morning. It's our second day. We're gonna go to the Galapagos today, but we have to go to another airport called Guayaquil first, and then fly to Baltar and the Galapagos Islands. Okay, this is our plane.
It looks like it, doesn't it?
It was just done.
All right, we are on the island of Baltra in the Galapagos. We are here. Okay, Grace number two. What island are we on?
No, we're not on any island. We're sitting next to
Very you. Good. Gotta move back. Forget birds.
Go ahead,
Phil.
I guess.
Alright.
Uh-huh.
Maybe in there, but I don't think that's a finch's nest.
He'll probably come back next time.
The frigate bird?
Hey, more than one.
this morning we got up and boated, got on our pongas, our dinghies, and headed for the north shore of San Cristobal. It was a beautiful morning. The weather was incredible. And some of us were going to swim that day and see some incredibly wonderful animals for the first time.
These are the juveniles of the cellulite crab. Blend right in with the lava rock. These are the mature crabs. They, once they get to this size and strength, they don't care if they're seen, so they get the bright colors. This is two absolutely beautiful. This is bull seal.
Right in the middle. Just like he says, here I am.
Look at that bull seal down there.
The color. This is the color. And because of the type of spines, they are not so sharp. They are, the tips are rounded. Mm-hmm. Never touch the sea urchins, just in case, because having not sharp spines, they don't hurt too much. But if somebody tries to step, I have seen a couple of times, even passing.
These are oyster catchers. They've from Central and South America. They've flown out here and now are part of the island. Here's the marine iguana. Feeding there, it was.
Make ceviche. There is the octopus.
Oh, wow, check it out. Oh,
look the color.
Yeah, tropical.
His name is Tsukutake. That's Japanese for octopus hole.
After that's the rail that broke. The rock.
That's the rock.
You know what? This is so good.
They've seen
the rock.
This
rock is called the Sleeping Lion. See some marine iguanas. They're everywhere. The baby seal. Sea lion. Not seal.
That's a small one over there.
That's a baby.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll go. With him. Studly guy.
This is a nesting albatross. They only nest, it's the only time they come on land. It's the nest. The rest of the year they're flying. They can fly around the whole world, but they always come back here. What did it do? Yeah, that wasn't a good one.
Now the albatross come over here and just leave, I would imagine.
Like if I were
like
there.
Like that guy just yeah.
did. I know, I see it. Isn't that just cool? But, one slip and he's in trouble. Imagine.
If we could cut cross country. It's an albatross flight. Beautiful birds. Another one.
Pictures
and
you get in and you go, oh my gosh,
I finally put it away.
Well, you just kind of have to.
It's
just
Christmas iguana.
Everything.
That's what they call it. Got icicles on it, red and green collars.
Exceptional view.
Exceptional.
She
stood up. She
leaped. And I could see the angle. So. It's the albatross. Yeah.
Imagine they cannot touch a really huge prey.
But
the lizards, they are excellent for them. They have to catch them by the neck, and then they turn long, and then they squeeze constrictors from the same family of anacondas. Exactly, abandon.
We got a Darwin's finch making a nest right next to the albatross. Thank you.
right hand, please. Okay. Okay.
Why can't we go up that ladder there? The island of Santa Cruz. This is where the Charles Darwin Research Center is. And Puerto Ayora.
Good, help yourself.
Then think about how the plant could. How to get fresh water in the up? When it's raining in Galapagos, it's excellent for them because they move quite fast. And then they.
The turtles from Santiago. Each island's kept separate. Because they're a different species.
Well, here is from several weeks to 3 years old.
So like
and over there, 2 years to 5 or 6 years.
They're tooing up and they start mixing all the species together because they'll be able to tell them apart by their shape. That's Lonesome George, the last species of turtle, tortoise, from his island. And they've introduced two similar turtles from other tortoises from other islands, females. Trying to get him to mate, but who knows?
He's picky.
They are from Galapagos. They are from Galapagos.
I just wonder if it wouldn't upset them.
They're going to sit on the back.
Here as well. I remember as well in Quito we had.
Oh, what a shot. He's smiling for you guys right now. And with the little bird, the warbler.
He's right on him.
Wild.
She moves too fast. That's the problem.
She's trying to get away from him. Hey, you need to stay
that
there,
was a
girl.
Roll.
Checking her out.
Something like that, and he's gonna pick up on it.
I think in the case of red tides must be fair amount. Then
somebody better draw a picture here.
The moment when they are ready for mating, that the males they become territorialists and they chase the females. And when they have already one next to
one of the things
from which I that could be a dominance thing too.
Because of them with females and to see them. Here we finish, huh? So that here you will have that
chicken.
Oh, look at that.
Oh,
hola. There we go.
Amazing.
We've seen in here. It's a private school, so it's, I think, I'm sure better off than the public schools, but this is where we are.
I know, that was just behind my, she said to be behind your child. Well,
she's your email addresses, perhaps we can continue an exchange. Okay, we have some cards to give out. And you'll be able to gain insights into not just school life, but
like you to share what you know about your environment with our students who are in an equally delicate environment, and we're striving to work for that too. So we're hoping to have a really great time, and we're sorry it's very short, but we're hoping to make the best of it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I think we have the biggest adult group.
Okay. Well, I saw that. I know what this is. Playground.
Okay.
Well, as you see, this is an art class.
Class sizes are quite small at the school. It's really nice, I think, our biggest class.
So they roost in the classrooms or in the bathrooms.
Come and go, it's part of their territory.
Are we about ready?
Thank you.
Thank you, muchas gracias.
We know they wanted them to stay, too.
Well, we wanted to stay.
Gosh, I would like to just want to sleep.
So, are we not going to go shopping?
No.
They just went by.
Cerro Dragon.
Cerro Dragon.
Great.
Hill.
What do they eat? What is he trying to get?
This hill is Dragon Hill right here.
You are anything but, my dear.
Just coming up through those wet rocks. Where did he come from?
Thank God.
Here's the shape of it. It's like a little promotion picture.
Because they depend on the temperature of the environment, so that they prefer not to be exposed too much to cold and wet.
Eradicated the feral dogs that used to be here. They had to actually move the iguanas out to another island until they could get rid of them. Goat skull, goat and burl. The islands were like millions of years ago when they were originally formed. basically no living things.
Because the plenty of gases, they permit this component to explode, so that the lava could be even broken because of forces of explosions of gases.
Another reason that another person cannot understand what they're talking. I'm trying to ask you to repeat again. This conversation is not nice. To call attention of the waiter, it's enough to raise a head. It's very bad. Whistle, shout, scream. Well, the waiter doesn't pay attention. I mean, but one experienced waiter also can see, because he has to keep eye on the table he served. He's going to see if somebody's looking for attention. So, well, I think this one is for white wine, for red wine. You're not drinking now, I mean, you're not full age, but in future you're going, the white wine we are always serving with.
Oh. You got goats and pelican chicks.
Right here with the pelican.
I got a
smell island. Volcanoes everywhere.
No, that is Ecuador. Wolf? Darwin.
Wolf? Largest and biggest group of iguanas we've ever seen. See, like, these are probably tip to tail, the snout, 3.5 feet, 4 feet. Maybe some of these are pushing 4 feet. Isabella Island over there, where we just were. Danino. Danina. Horns on the nose are modified scales. Mangroves can live in brackish water.
It was not neither a primary eruption.
Right.
It was a secondary, so that in here we couldn't see the eruption. It was occurring along a fault. Even now can be erupting and we don't notice.
Could be just flowing really nice.
4 days maybe, and perhaps maybe this group of islands.
These depressions are the nest of the rain iguanas. Big one to start chasing the sun off. Santiago Island. We were moving all night. Went from the southern hemisphere into the northern hemisphere around Isabela and then back down. Now we're back in the southern hemisphere again.
person has been visiting the island, and they arrived to the first volcano located at the other side of the bay. The first small volcano, very flat.
Yeah. Okay. Mockingbird, different variety. Charter beak. Would be an endemic species, I'm sure.
Which is the one
way, way, way out there?
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Which is the food for them?
Those two is turning on.
It's algae. Okay. It's not the algae, it's floating.
Mm-hmm. Huh?
It's
there's
just
two
the
out there.
Covering the rock, so that they have to fall on the rock, they have to swim.
Pieces or seashells.
Okay. Thank you. Would have a huge advantage. Right.
Charles.
Rock, which is made of red sand.
But in nature, it's like that. Small, big like that, depending on. That is.
We are on the small island of Rabida. Rabido. Rabida. Something like that.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
We saw so yesterday.
Well, that kind of.
With a head.
Jumping and spinning in the air. They look like the whale, a plume of a whale, that's what I thought they were.
Look at that.
This to get lucky. They want to do it. If they don't, they will.
So, Grace, this area, if it was accessible, would make a really excellent snorkeling area, right? Because
right there. They do have nesting pelicans. Maybe.
Okay. I think you should go.
This
somebody should go.
This is the post office. It's not the original one. That's where sailors would leave.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. We are going messages to take a picture
in barrels.
You can have all the pictures
and then other sailors would pick them up and deliver them if they were going to an area where the letter was to.
Those are the older ones. Or from the middle.
You have your card in there still.
I might have my card in there. It has never come back.
Santa Barbara, Arizona, California.
Okay, so let me grab a California.
That is the group, Ramona.
Oh, okay.
Pelican is there. Bush. Up there. Pelican. Maybe sea turtles. Pay attention on pelicans. They move.
Lions.
Chest.
Now you know all of that.
And there's a lot of birds up in that mangrove.
Up in there, up on the... Oh, look at the one right at the top. See it? Right at the top.
It's snorkeling in a swimming pool.
This is the engine room tour that we were able to arrange. Several of us went into the engine, and then Lee came back later with his camcorder. For those of you who are mechanically inclined, this could have been a heaven for you like it was for Lee. He talked about this for hours.
Our schedule, even though they give it to us. Man at the bottom of this one. I thought that was real cute. This is the main lounge. I don't know if I've shown any of this before. Kids are practicing for their presentation they're going to do.
Yeah,
bar.
You're
dogs now, of course, obviously. This will be leaving the lounge. This is the reception area. This is kind of where the hub of everything. The stairs. A little boutique. Camera broke. What's going on?
Okay, so you're going to do slimy brown seafood.
The library.
And you do the other one. Now, it would be nice if somebody colored these in appropriate colors. Except for white is white, but slimy brown should look like slimy brown. It's something that's hard to see without being colorful.
This is to the sun deck. There's one on each side of the ship. The bridge. Gotcha. Back this bridge again. It's just a partial deck. That's where all the kids are at down below. That's below the waterline. Okay, anyway, the battery went dead. I'm not sure how far I got with this. Anyway, we're on the starboard side. And our cabin's actually on the port side. And I'm heading in. Can take another set of stairs. Two more sets of stairs and get to the sun deck from down here. And yeah.
Oh, goodness. Is this amazing?
Yeah.
She's got good eyes, this Grace. She does. She has excellent. I just don't want her to cross the street.
She has good eyes, that Grace.
A giant tortoise.
Don't approach more, please, until here. No more.
Sitting on the side of the road, I'm eating. Driving to the highlands of Santa Cruz. Of course, type terrain. Let's go up with this coffee.
Keep going, yeah, keep going, yeah. Mm-hmm. When the volcanic activity stopped, yeah, there was no more lava coming from the crater. The lava that
I'm gonna follow.
Very beautiful. Working on it. Then we had a little bit of free time for
welcome
the last few days.
Welcome to Nacho's Great Adventure.
Oh, look, an iguana.
I'm a marine iguana. That's Nacho. He knows everything. And that goes to that.
They eat shrimp and krill, which gives them their
right there. It's right there. Right under.
That is like 8 feet long.
Look at the difference.
Thanks. I want our bus for city tour. We're going to go to Old Quito. This is our basically, other than going to the airport in the morning. This okay, we stopped and got out. Let's see. We got purposes. The elevations up here provide moisture. Quito is just immense. Shackling the reptiles represent evil.
Quito is a very modern city, and from this vantage point we could look out and see 360 degrees. It's a city of about 4 million people. Later we were going to see a peak of the tip of this volcano, because the clouds usually cover it. So as the sun is setting, we're able to look at this glacier-covered peak that's representative of many that surround the Quito area.
Oh, look at the purple.
The city of Quito is starting to improve many of their older parts of the city. A lot of renovation going on, and these new lights have just been put up, and they plan to do the whole old city like this for nighttime. It's incredible. It was a wonderful trip. We will have many, many, many fond memories as the year goes by. Thank you for your cooperation and your fun on your trip, on this trip. I will always remember you. Thank you.